So today we're gonna be doing a chit chat and get ready with me. This is going to be like a very like kind of sort of glam look, but not really. We're not gonna be doing a lot of contouring or anything like that. We're just gonna be doing a simple, like I said, sort of simple look. But for today, I'm gonna be doing something a little bit different. I'm gonna be doing my face makeup first, and then I'm gonna go into doing my eye makeup. So we're just gonna be starting off with this primer right here, and this is the Baby Skin Primer. And I always use this primer, so it's not really anything new. This to me is definitely really good for like blurring out your pores and stuff. So like if you're gonna be applying foundation, this is perfect for that. Well, obviously it's for that, but like it's perfect to like if you have like really large pores, then this really helps to minimize them and make them a lot smoother. So for foundation, we're gonna be using this today because I've been using the other one too much. So I'm using the L'Oreal foundation, and this is a drugstore foundation. So technically a lot of my videos are pretty much affordable like makeup. Like I'm using all affordable makeup pretty much. So I need more foundation on. Yeah, this is definitely like a medium to full coverage foundation. More medium than full, but you can build it up to a full coverage. So for concealer, I'm going to be using the NYX HD Concealer. I'm also going to be using this concealer right here, LA Pro Coverage, in the color Cool Tan. And this is in the color Tan Bronze. So, yeah. By the way, this concealer, I'm always using this concealer. And this concealer is really good. It's like an HD photogenic concealer. So, really good for pictures and stuff. The only thing I don't like about this concealer is that it oxidizes a lot. Like, it's just ridiculous how much it oxidizes. Like, right now before your very eyes, it is oxidizing. And it just looks very dark. It doesn't really cover much. That's why I have to layer it with, like a lighter concealer, because it doesn't really do much as far as highlighting goes. So, I'm going to be using this Anastasia concealer. Where's my... Okay, this thing is crusty. So this is like the Anastasia concealer. I had to mix this with oil because it dried up because I lost the cover for it. But I definitely kind of like mix these two together. We're gonna be going in now with the contouring and stuff, bronzing. Still don't know the difference, guys. Still don't know the difference. This hair is getting on my nerves. I don't have a hair tie. So I'm using the LA Pro Coverage Concealer in the color Beautiful Bronze. I'm gonna be using this to like bronze up, I mean contour my face. This is what I always do. I don't really have anything different that I do as far as contouring goes. I know we said we weren't going to do anything too crazy, but this is just a must when it comes to like a full face of makeup. Like this is something you want to do. You don't want to skip this step because it definitely gives your face more definition and it makes you look like you're wearing more makeup. Like whenever you're doing like a makeup tutorial, you want to make sure that you put enough makeup on so when you take your pictures, it looks like you have something on. You want to make sure that you look like you have makeup on, because then someone's gonna look at your thumbnail and be like, does she even have makeup on? Like, what's going on? So yeah, you want your makeup to show. That's why when you're doing makeup tutorials, it's okay to look cakey, like off camera, but like on camera, like, I don't know, the camera really doesn't pick up on cake. Like if you look super like you have like a full face of makeup, like everything just looks caked, then on camera it shouldn't look that way compared to like in person. I don't know if that makes any sense. I didn't really think about that one, but you guys know what I mean. Bronze up our face, so we're gonna be using this right here, and this is the Bella Pierre. I always use this, by the way, and I'm just gonna be going in this color right here. So this is my dusting brush, sort of, kind of using the blush brush. So I'm just gonna be going in with the orange. Show you guys. So this is going to set your contour. So you're just gonna go in and set it. I'm going to move on to my under eyes real quick because that part is so, like, I really don't care about my under eyes, to be honest, no matter what. So I'm going to be going in, so I'm going to be going into the Jaclyn Hill palette, and I'm going in with, let's do that soft brown color. So I'm going in with this color right here. My face is looking beat, guys. Mm-hmm. Trying to get more people to check out your videos, do stuff that are simple. You can still be dramatic if you're that, if you're like that kind of like extra person, like you love to do extra looks, you're just extra in general, then you could do that by all means. But you want to be versatile, you want to be able to do glam makeup looks and also do very simple, you know, outgoing looks, things that you can wear out, and looks that are very simple, easy to do, because not everyone has really good makeup skills, not everyone can do makeup, so you want to be able to reach out to different people, like a different audience. So that's just my advice to you guys. I don't know what I was doing with that.
Tell me what you say now. Tell me what you say, come again. If you cannot stay down, then you do not have to pretend like there is no way out. I should've never let you in, 'cause you got me face down. And don't take this personal. What you say? You said that you would come again. You said that we would remain friends, but you know that I do not depend on nothing or no one. So why would you show up so uninvited? Then just change my mind like that. Please don't take this personal. special till I made you so. You better act like you know that I've been